Now I invite Nusrat Javid, president of SAFMA, to say some words, few words.
Well, thank you very much to all of you. Imtiaz Alam Saab has forced me to speak because in our close, I'm in session, I have done enough subversion. I don't want to continue with that. But there are one or two points, because since Imtiaz Saab insists that I should also speak here in open forum, relatively more open, that wasn't that open either. Because I don't think in Pakistan, and especially in Islamabad, that too in Marriott basement, you can ever have a closed session. So it goes where it has to go. And thank God we are living in that way in a proper city which is well protected, where nothing is that close. Coming to Khalid Saab is almost a mentor. By the way, I'm also one of the anchors who uses but Urdu language, which is now being exposed to be, you know, inciting various things and then denying international, narrative about us. Let me tell you, Khalid Saab, first of all, and it's very difficult for me to use very polite words, so doing self-censoring. This international so-called narrative, that gave us Ziaulhaq and his 11 years. This international narrative made us believe that that dictator who was flogging us in public, who hanged an elected prime minister, was fighting for the freedom of so-called free world. That market economy fighter, that Mujahid, he was promoted by the same international narrative. And I pay two hoots to them. I tell you, not one American diplomat based here, I challenge them, they can go to any court of law. They had been telling me throughout Musharraf's period that there is but one person who can deliver, and his name is General Musharraf, and why you oppose him. So these two dictators who spoiled our society, who gave us all these loonies, and now all of a sudden international narrative blames me? Give me a break. This CIA sponsored, this British military intelligence, weren't they in negotiation with Haqqani until 10 days ago? International narrative says that I am backing Haqqanis. What they had been doing with Haqqani? Haqqani was living in Islamabad. Don't tell me Americans had not been meeting Haqqani. Don't force me to name names. I want to survive as well. So, I mean, don't simplify it like that. Games this CIA has played, game this so-called international narrative had played, that has brought us where we are today. This madness was financed by CIA, this madness was financed by Saudi Arabia, and it was fully supported by the so-called Renaissance-driven freedom and, you know, liberty and liberalism promoting our donors. This donor-driven narrative, I refuse to accept. And as far as my language is concerned, my language, my mother language is not Urdu. My mother language is Punjabi, and my language has given me Bulle Shah. Give me one English line which can compete Bulle Atan Kafir Ka Farah De Tu Aho Aho Ka. This is what my culture has inherited. This is what I had heard in the lap of my mother when I was a kid. You are telling me that what my mother told me, I will forget it? No, I can't. He was a Sayyid. He said ke bulle nu jada kafir aake Sayyid Sayyid ke lave in a caste-driven society. Isse zyada liberating kaun sa experience hai? I give two hoots to this international narrative. I don't care for that. And if I speak for that, I will continue to do that. And I think Pakistan's elite, especially the urban elite, and the people who you are saying are now trying to integrate us with international narrative, no. They are their agents of influence. And unfortunately, if people of Pakistan, sadly Khalisa was very right if they don't trust them, because they do not speak in their lingo, because they do not use the symbols which they do, and then they do not expose the hypocrisies of this international narrative producers are. In that case, then you have very nice anchors who are coming here, and then what is happening? Basically, this television, sir, it's a very, very costly business. It requires investment of millions. It's purely market driven. And market, sir, is driven by telemeters. And telemeters, 400, they are put in Karachi. Karachi tells you that what someone living in Khuzdar and Turbat should see, because on the basis of that so-called market report, and then of course, please dig further, sir, 70% of people who assign or give business to these business groups, I mean people from UFON, etc., they are also card-carrying members of MQM. It so happens. And when you come to the state, you know, who can't survive unless there is a wisdom provided by one military expert here, Zaid Hamad, who this person, this anchor who speaks Urdu, I call him a joker. That joker is presented as expert on defense affairs by none other than Pakistan television, state-run television. Under a government, Benazir Bhutto is considered to be killed by them. Those elements are now dominate Pakistan television, sir, not the private television, I'm afraid. And then also, please, this very government, who are the owners who are pal to them and where they are often found. So I just beg of you that Pakistan must not be isolated. We should be a sane society and all that. But that doesn't mean that narrative for me can be discovered and articulated by someone else. It has to be discovered by me. It's our struggle. We are struggling for it. Even this morning, I talked of one pressure that a lady, and I never feel shy of naming names. I told you, Sumaira Malik, MNA goes to meet leader of the opposition, Mia Nawaz Sharif. And who is putting pressure? CBR and Ministry of Interior people of the government of Pakistan People's Party. None of them would ever call me, even if I abuse Asif Ali Zardari or Yusuf Raza Gilani in my programs. So these are the realities we are working in. So whatever is happening, I don't think I should be speaking more. I did my subversion in a closed session. No more. Thank you very much.